Dear student, today I am going to discuss acceleration due to gravity concept. Let's see what is acceleration due to gravity. Acceleration due to gravity. You know it is denoted by small g. Now let's see how to understand the basic concept of acceleration due to gravity. Let's see, this is suppose that Earth having radius r and mass of the Earth, let that is capital M. Another object of mass small m lying over the surface. Let's see, weight of this particular object will act downward direction and center is O. Now if I am taking two point masses, one is this, another is this, the force which is acting downward, that will be mg. Force of gravitation acting between them, that is let fg. Now at equilibrium, because it is in stable equilibrium, at equilibrium you can write fg, that is the gravitational force between m and capital M. This is capital M and this is small m, and separation between them I can write, that will be capital R here, because this is the radius only which is separation between them, that will be mg. Now what is fg, gravitational force? I can write it capital G, capital M, small m upon R square. R square means capital R square, which is equal to small mg. Now mm will cancel out. What you are getting, that is the value of g, which is equal to gm upon R square. This is the formula you should remember for a long time. Acceleration due to gravity only depends upon the mass of the Earth, mass of the planet you can say, radius as well as gravitational constant. One thing you have to notice here, that is an important note for you, that is acceleration due to gravity is independent of the mass of an object. It means it won't affect where you have an iron ball of 10 kg and plastic ball of 1 kg falling from a certain height. Both have same acceleration due to gravity. This is one body and let this is other body. Both have same acceleration due to gravity. Remember this fact. Acceleration due to gravity is independent of the mass of object. Okay. Now, near to the surface of Earth near to Earth, acceleration due to gravity can be calculated. You know g is 6.67 10 raised to power minus 11 into mass of the Earth x is into 10 raised to power 24 kg. Radius of the Earth is 6400 kilometers. 64 kilometer means 10 raised to power 3 square of this. And when you solve it carefully, you will get approximately its value will be 9.8 meters per second square. This is the value near to the surface of Earth or above the surface of Earth up to a certain height. But when you go above the certain height or below the Earth in a depth, in a long depth, value of this particular acceleration due to gravity will change. First of all, I want to tell you how acceleration due to gravity will vary according to altitude or height. So I am writing here variation of g with height. Let's see. This is the surface of Earth. And up to a certain height, I have taken an object because I have taken this object upward. Initially, object was here. Now it will be here. This is point B, and let this is point A. And mass of the Earth is capital M, and radius of the Earth I am taking from the center, that will be R. Let's see how do you apply the concept here. I can write, let this height I am taking H, and I can here write at surface of the Earth, that means at point A, at position A, acceleration due to gravity, I can write g is equal to gm upon up to the A, distance from the center, that will be r. I can write here r square. This is the acceleration due to gravity at point A. Similarly, at point B, it varies. That's why I am writing it g dash, which is equal to gm. And distance you have to take from the center between the two point masses. Point masses means center is here, and total mass of the Earth concentrated at its center. That's where separation become r plus h. I can write here r plus h whole square. Now, when you compare, let this is equation 1 and this is equation 2. When you compare equation 1 and 2, compare 1 and 2. Let's see what you're getting. You will get g dash upon g, which is equal to gm upon r plus h whole square into r square upon gm. You can cancel out. Gm, gm will cancel out, and you will get g dash upon g, that is equivalent to r square divided by r plus h whole square. Now, take r square common in denominator. When you take common, it will be 1 plus h upon r whole square. R square again cancel out. You will get g dash by g, that will be equivalent to 1 plus h by r raised to power minus 2. Now, you have to use the binomial theorem here, BT theorem. BT theorem means 1 plus x raised to power minus n, that will be 1 minus nx, plus also higher term you have to take here, but I will neglect the higher term because this is very smaller value. Only first two term I am going to consider. That's why I can write in the previous equation g dash upon g, that will be equivalent to 1 minus 2h upon r. And finally, g dash will be g into 1 minus 2h upon r. Remember this formula whenever you are dealing with the maximum height, higher value of the height. And up to, you know, 100 kilometers, 10 kilometers, 1000 kilometers, we have different variations. You should remember it. What are these different variations? Right now, I have told you about only variation of the height. And very shortly, I will tell you about the variation of depth as well as rotation, shape, all. But this formula you have to multiply. Note, this is my own approximation. You can apply this formula only height, approximately 10 kilometer to 500 kilometer. When height is below this, no need to apply this formula. You only apply G, that is 9.8. Only above this height you can apply this formula. And if you want to calculate this value, that will be in case of the percentage also. In percentage, G dash is divide G, multiply it inside, that will be G into 2H upon R. Now, change in acceleration due to gravity, I can write by this way, that will be multiplied by 100, which is equal to minus 2H upon R into 100. By this way, you can also calculate the percentage of it.